Hello and welcome to the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. My name is Dylan and I am your host today. So this week we're looking at an interesting topic that I'm sure many of you will be interested in, and that is winter sports. So have you been watching the Winter Olympics? What's your favourite sport? What has been your favourite event so far? Let me know in the comment section. So let's say hello. So let's take a look. We've got Sawin says, hello, hi. How are you? I am very good, Ishrat. How is things with you? All good. Hello in Lima. Hi. Hi from Liverpool, where it is a very, very windy day. There's a big storm here. Terrible weather. So if you hear a noise, that is the storm kicking off. Okay, we got Kiara, hi, good to see you again. And Nora, hello. Stop. Lots of familiar faces. Hi, Jessica, great to see you again. So, good afternoon, everybody. So, you know the drill by now. There are 8 questions in total. We do the questions first and the answers second. So questions first, and then we look at the answers. It is just for fun. There are no prizes. It's just for fun. And please like, comment, and share. If you're having a good time, hit that like button. Please comment, because the more you are active in your learning, the more likely you are to remember. And of course, share with your friends and family members. All right, we'll do a few more hellos. We got Margarita. Hi, in Veneto, in Italy. We got hello from Ecuador, Uzbekistan, from Sudan. We've got from Guinea and Bangladesh and Vietnam and Eritrea. Lovely to see an international audience with us again today. So hi, everybody. Without further ado, should we get started? Let's go. Off we go with round one. And let's make it like that. Yes. Okay. So round one. Okay, we're going to look at the vocabulary question. Cairo came third. He has won the medal. A, bronze, B, bronze, C, brown, or D, gold. So Cairo came third. He has won the medal. Bronze, brown, or gold medal. What do you think? A, B, C, or D? All right, we got a few people coming in with B, nice and early. B, Dan, Jessica, B, some D's coming in. We got a few C's, a few A's, but mostly B, I think. So bronze seems to be the most popular choice. Let's move on to question number 2. Okay, so here, we're looking for the word in the blank space. Okay, so I'm rooting the skater in blue. I hope he does well. Is it rooting for, rooting with, or rooting to? Okay, so this will be a phrasal verb. Okay, but it's not so common, so I think it might be a bit tricky for some of you. It might be the first time you've heard it. But even if you don't know, take a guess. All right, we've got 2A, we got Dan's gone for B, A from Uzair, Napason has gone for rooting 2. So this is when you're supporting somebody, you want them to do well, you're hoping that they do well in their sport, in their competition, or the interview, you're rooting A for, B with, or C 2. Keep your answers coming in. On we go. Round 3. So round 3 is going to be a spelling round, which we don't do too often. And I want you to complete the words. We've got 4 winter sports. What are the words and how do you spell them? So we've got some popular winter sports, yeah. All of these are in the Olympics, so you might have been watching them recently. Okay, but what are these? We've got Hidiko says the T is loot, L-O-O-T. Do you agree with Hidiko? Let's see what else we've got here. Ashraf says number one or A is curling. Okay. Darin, you've never seen these before? Well, you've got four new words to learn then. Sharina is saying skateboard. Now, skateboarding is a sport. Is it a winter sport? Have a little think. It's close. It's half right. All right. We got curling. Susanna says snowboarding, as does Sanaya Maria. Okay, the answers are coming in. Juan Humberto saying A, curling, B, snowboarding. Two more to get. For C, there are two correct spelling. There's the British way and there's the American way. Obviously, here at BBC Learning English, we're teaching British English, so I put the British spelling up. Okay. Bobsleigh. Okay, so bobsleigh, but how is the correct spelling? How is it spelt? All right. So keep your answers coming in. Snowboarding. Curling, snowboarding. All right then. So keep your answers coming in, but we're going to move on. Remember, questions first, answers later on. On we go to the round four of the BBC Learning English Live Friday Quiz. If you've just joined us, we do the questions first and we look at the answers later on. Aha. So this is something that is commonly confused by English language learners, okay? So we should all ice skating this winter. Do we use do, go, play, or nothing? X means no word. We should all ice skating this winter. Do, go, play, or nothing? Okay. So, nice variety of answers coming in. Play, go, play, and play. So B and C are the most popular answers. But what do you think? Get your answers coming in. We should all ice skating this winter. What do you think? All right, then. And we're going to move on to round five, which is our special mystery guest round. And we're welcoming back a good friend of the show, Nina.
Hi, Dylan. How are you?
Hi, Nina. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Very happy it's Friday.
It's always a good feeling, isn't it?
Indeed.
Okay. And how's the weather with you?
Oh, we're in this storm as well. So it's been pretty crazy. Definitely a day for staying indoors, I think.
Certainly is. And have you been watching the Winter Olympics?
I have. I've been pretty busy, so I haven't had lots of time to watch it. But when I've had some free time, I have been watching all the Olympics that I can.
Okay. And what's your favourite sport at the Olympics?
I like anything on ice. So I like the ice hockey. I like figure skating.
Okay. And I think you have a related question on that theme. Am I right?
I do. So my question is, the place where ice hockey and ice skating, my favourite sports, take place is called, is it A, pitch, B, ring, C, court, or D, rink?
Okay. So we're looking for the place where ice hockey or ice skating is done. Is that correct, yeah?
Yes, yeah. So it's the area of ice that you have ice skating, ice hockey.
Okay, and what are the four choices?
So they are A, pitch, B, ring, C, court, or D, rink.
Okay, all right then. Nice question. So what are your plans for the rest of the day, Nina?
I am not going anywhere. I'm going to be warm and hopefully catch a little bit of the Olympics.
Yeah, it's a nice day for hibernating, relaxing, chilling out, isn't it?
Exactly.
Okay, thanks for joining us. See you again.
Good with the quiz, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay, lots of people saying hello, Nina. So, hi, Nina, if you're watching. We've got, ring and rink seem to be the most popular answers, though Shireen has gone for C. Rink, rink, ring and rink coming in. We got court, court. Oof, okay. So you're not quite sure this one. These are quite commonly confused, and they are, it is quite difficult piece of vocabulary, this. So I look forward to going through the answers later on. All right, deal. Round six. Grammar time. I know it's Friday. I know we're here to have a good time, but we've got to do a little bit of grammar. Okay. So, Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have a medal. Now, are we saying A, whether Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won? B, if Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won? Or C, even if Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won a medal? So are we going for A, B, or C? All right, so Samantha's coming in already. Shireen going for A, weather and won. Edwin's going for C. We've got Lydia going for C. And Shahul's going for if and win. So this is it's quite a tough question, and these are quite commonly confused. Whether, if, and even if are quite tough to know. And of course, if you'd like to know more about grammar in general, be sure to go to our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where we've got loads and loads of grammar content for you. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, of course. But we've got a nice variety of answers coming in. This is what I like to see. Okay, let's move on. Question number seven. Phrasal verb question for you. So you're really good at ice hockey. You should the team. Okay, so we're trying to say that we should try and get in the team. But what is the correct phrasal verb? A, try out. B, try out for. C, try with. Or D, try on. So you're really good at ice hockey. You should the team. So you should try and get on the team. Is it A, try out, B, try out for, C, try with, or D, try on? What do you think? Try with, try with, try with. We've got A's, a few A's coming in. Try out. Napasan, try out. But are they correct? Okay, C, D, D, B. Oh, I think it's a bit of a tough quiz today. Lots of different answers coming in here. All right, what else we got? Try out for, try with. Try with, says Evgeny. Fong's going for, Fong, sorry, your name's Fong. You've gone, sorry. Rachel's going for, Wahid is going for D. Okay. Let's move on. Round eight. And our last question before we look at the important part, which is the answers, is a question about adjectives, vocabulary question. So which of these adjectives is not usually described, not usually used to describe athletes? A, muscular. B, robust. C, flabby. D, energetic. E, flexible. Or F, agile. Okay, so which of these adjectives is not used to describe athletes? Okay, so F, C, C, flabby. Okay, we've got a few people coming in. D, energetic. We have got A, C, the answer is B, says Sada. Okay, and most people are going for C. I think it's quite a popular one. Darlene, Maru and Carla all going for C, but Agile's getting a few as well. Okay, so stick around and we'll take a look at the answers now. So, can I cast your mind back 10 minutes to round one? We looked at this question. Cairo came third. He has won the medal. Is it A, bronze medal, B, the bronze medal, C, the brown medal, or D, the gold medal? Dum-da-da-dum. And the correct answer, as many of you got, is B. Yes, so if you come first in the Olympics, you get the gold medal. Second is silver. And third, you will get a bronze medal. B-R-O-N-Z-E, bronze, the bronze medal. So, well done if you got that right. A nice, easy question to start off with to warm you up for the quiz. Round two. A little bit trickier here. So I'm rooting the skater in blue. I hope he does well. So we're looking, it's what you're saying, that we're supporting somebody. We want them to do well. I'm rooting the skater in blue. What do you think? 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is rooting for. Okay, rooting for. I'm rooting for the skater in blue. I hope he does well. So root for is a phrasal verb. It means to show your support for the success of somebody. You're supporting them. You are backing them. You want them to do well. So this is quite an informal, relaxed phrasal verb. I wouldn't necessarily use it in formal situations and certainly not in academic writing. It's, I think it's more common in American English than in British English, but we definitely know it and we're familiar with it and we use it. I use it. An important thing to note about this phrasal verb is we don't usually use it to talk about the teams or the people which we regularly support. So I support Liverpool, my football team. I don't say I'm rooting for Liverpool because I support them. I support them every week. But maybe in the Olympics and there's somebody new and you say, like, okay, the Jamaican bobsleigh team. You go, okay, I'm rooting for them because it's not something I do every week. It's just for this special occasion. So who have you been rooting for in this Olympics? Okay, let's take a look. An example from Bill, I'm rooting for player 67. All right. Tangina, no problem. Better luck in the next questions coming up. Okay. Let's have a look. Ted says, I'm rooting for you. Thank you. I hope you're talking about to me. Okay. Let's have a look. All right then. Good job. Lots of you saying you got that correct. So well done to everyone who did. Dan's got 1 out of 8. Good job, Dan. Let's move on then. Let's move on to question 3. Huda says, I'm not rooting for anybody. Nice example sentence. Thank you, Huda. Okay. Let me just put that away. All right, round 3. Round 3. Trickier question today, which is our spelling round. And I know I'm very horrible. I've given you 4 words to spell, 4 different words, but we've got 4 new words to learn. Let's put it in the positive way, shouldn't we? Okay. So we got 4 sports. So I'm going to say them and then we look at the spelling. So the first one is curling, B, snowboarding, C, bobsleigh, and D is the luge. Curling, snowboarding, bobsleigh, and the luge. And the correct spellings are like these here. So C-U-R-L-I-N-G. Snowboarding, 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 bobsleigh. So bobsleigh is the British term for it. In American English, they call it bobsled, B-O-B-S-L-E-D. British, bobsleigh. American, bobsled. And then D is the luge. Now, the luge looks like quite an intense sport, quite a dangerous sport to me, and I wouldn't fancy that. But which winter sports do you enjoy watching or doing? What have you been enjoying in this Olympics? So how to play luge? So the luge, okay, first of all, we don't say play luge, we just luge. So we can use it as a verb. And the luge is when you lie on a small sled on your back and you race downhill feet first. You have to be very brave to do it because they go very, very, very fast. Okay, listen. So Zakara, like big ice hockey fan. You want to try the luge, then you are braver than me. Bobsleigh is a team sport. Yes, so there is the two-person bobsleigh or the four-person bobsleigh. Okay, so Estes asks, what sport are you fancy of? So instead of saying this, we say, what sport are you fancy of? I think we just say, what sport do you like? What sport do you enjoy? Or what sport are you a fan of? A fan of. What sport are you a fan of? Okay, we got a figure skating fan here. Curling, snowboarding, good job there. Let's do it. Darine is a big swimming fan. Did short track, good. Snowboarding's good, says Frederick. All these sports take place in the cold places. I'm not a fan of the cold, so I've never enjoyed winter sports. Okay. Right. So let's have a look. Okay, let's move on then. How are you doing so far? Anybody got 3 out of 3? Let me know if you have. Good job, because these are some tricky questions. Aha. So this one, we're looking for the correct choice of verb. So we should all ice skating this winter. We should all do, we should all go, we should all play, or we should all ice skating this winter. A, B, C, or D. Now, do, play, and go with sports is tricky, and I see many of my students struggle with this. So this is why we're looking at it here. We should all ice skating this winter. And tell me your answer and tell me why. Why do we use that one? Okay, 3 more seconds. We got 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is B, go. So well done to anybody who got that correct. We should all go ice skating this winter. So for team sports or ball games, we usually use play. I play football. I play tennis. I don't play rugby. Okay. Team sports, especially ones with a ball, play. Usually for individual activities, we use do. So I do exercise. I do judo. And then for activities which end in ing, okay, we often use go. So I can say, I go running, I go swimming, let's go ice skating. Okay, so a nice little tip for you there. If it ends in ing, it usually has go. And Huda's put it here for us. Thank you very much, Huda. Very, very useful. Sophia has given a nice example sentence. I often do yoga. Good. Okay, let's have a look. Go plus the gerund, yes, which is the ing word. Team sports, we use play, go swimming, go ice skating. Good. Let's go for shopping. Okay. And yes, we also use go for shopping and other activities with ing. Good. I go skiing. Thank you, Zakat. I go swimming. Good. It is as to say go swimming. Yes, Nixon, we say go swimming because it ends in the ing. Okay. Whew. Round five was Nina's question. Nina's vocabulary question. And this was about the place where ice hockey and ice skating takes place. Okay. Do we call it a pitch? Do we call it a ring? Do we call it a court? Or do we call it a rink? So A, B, C, or D. Is it a pitch? Is it a ring? Is it a court? Or is it a rink? What do you think? So another question that had a nice variety of answers. Last time, when we looked at it first, B and D seemed to be the most popular. But what do you think? Ring or rink? Yes. Okay. D, the answer is ice skating rink, ice hockey rink. Now, let's have a look at what these different words mean. So a pitch, this is an area used for mostly outside team sports. It's quite large. So we've got a football pitch and a rugby pitch. So it's usually with grass and it's usually outside. Pitch is used in British English. In America, they more commonly use field, football field, American football field. Here in the UK, we say pitch. A ring is used to describe the areas normally in fighting sports. So this includes boxing and wrestling or UFC, etc. And they used to be circular, which is why we call them a ring. So these the boxing matches used to take place in a circle ring, so they called them the ring. But nowadays they're frequently square, but we still call them a ring. A court is generally used for indoor sports involving two teams. And a court is usually smaller than a pitch and is made for team sports, normally for five or less players per team. So it's a bit smaller than a pitch. Often it is indoors. And then rink is for ice hockey and has ice. Okay, let's have a look at any tennis. Tennis, badminton, tennis court, badminton court, football pitch, hockey pitch, rugby pitch. So when we say hockey pitch, that is outside hockey, outdoor hockey, ice hockey rink, wrestling ring. Thank you very much. Yes. All right. Basketball court, tennis court. Good. Serena says, thanks, got it. Good. Glad you're getting it because, yeah, useful this. Okay, let's have a look. A table for table tennis. Yes, indeed. Yeah, you got it. Yeah, yeah. All right. Okay, no more questions. I can't see any questions, so let's move on. Boxing ring. Yes, a boxing ring, exactly that. We play basketball. In a court. Good. What is my favorite sport? My favorite sport is football. I love football. I'm a big football fan. And tomorrow, for the first time in a long, long time, I'm going to Anfield, Liverpool Stadium, to go and watch Liverpool play. I'm very, very excited about it. It's been a long time since I've been, even though the weather is supposed to be terrible, I'm very excited about going to see it. Okay. All right, round six. Grammar time. Grammar time. So, Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have a medal. Now, is it whether and when? Is it if and when? Or is it even if and when? What do you think? A, B, or C? Whether Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won the medal. If Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won the medal. Or C, even if Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won a medal. Okay. So, what do you think? Okay, I see a few Liverpool fans coming in. Okay, football fans, good to see it. But I love all sports, really. I also like rugby. So rugby is a big sport. I like a bit of tennis. And I'm really enjoying the Winter Olympics. Sports in general are fantastic. Watching more than doing now as I'm getting older. All right. So what do you think, A, B, or C for question number six? It is C. Even if Carlos had worked harder, he probably wouldn't have won a medal. Okay, let's take a look at why. So here we're talking about something hypothetical. So we're using even if to introduce hypothetical situations, imaginary situations, which might not be real. We're thinking about what would have happened if Carlos had worked harder. So the meaning is whether or not. We're emphasizing that it wouldn't have mattered. It wouldn't have made a difference to the final result. So if Carlos worked very hard, and if Carlos didn't work so hard, it doesn't matter. He still probably wouldn't win a medal. So let me give you one or two more examples. Okay. Even if it's a beautiful day, I'm not going out. This means if it rains, I'm not going out. If it's okay, I'm not going out. If it's beautiful, I'm not going out. So the result is the same regardless of what happens. So that's when we use even if. So A, whether and when. We could use whether if we change the grammar slightly. So it's wrong with the grammar here, but we could say whether or not Carlos had practiced harder, he wouldn't have won a medal. So even if is similar to whether or not. If and when doesn't work here. Okay, so if we used if, that would be the third conditional. And we use that by doing if plus the past perfect and the perfect conditional. So we should be using the past participle one, but grammatically, the sentence doesn't make sense. If Carlos would practice harder, he wouldn't have won a medal. It defies logic, doesn't really make sense, and it's the opposite of what we'd expect. So the correct answer is even if. Now, your question, can you make an example sentence with even if? Oh, okay. MD Russell, straight in. Even if Carlos had read harder, let's change read to studied. Okay. Even if Carlos had studied harder, he probably wouldn't have passed his exam. I love it. Salam. Even if the session is amazing, I have to leave. Well, thanks for joining us for a little bit anyway. Flattery will get you everywhere. Frederick, even if I'm busy, I would listen to you. Even if there is bad weather, we would still play football outside. Very brave of you, Yilin. Okay, even if it had rained a lot, I probably would have visited the park. Love it. Noshin, even if I walked faster, I wouldn't have reached my destination on time. Good. Okay. Okay, let's have a look. Any more example sentences? Okay. So Tangina's changed the order. Okay. So even he always looks neat and clean. Even if, let's go, even if it is a little out of style. So we're not, the subject isn't very clear here. So he always looks neat and clean, even if his clothes are a little out of style. We need to make sure that the subject of the sentence is very clear. Okay. Okay. We've got ourselves a romantic. Even if the ocean left the sea, there will still be me and you and me. All right. Romantic little rhyme there. Nice. And one more from Mayo. Even if John tried very hard, he would not pass the exam. Okay, so I think you've got it. Well done. Well done, everybody. I think this makes perfect example sentences there. And remember, when you learn something new, when you do write it or you use it, you're more likely to remember it. So making these example sentences, even if I don't put them up on the screen, is really useful because you are actively using that language. So it's more likely to stick in your memory long term. So well done. I can't show all the messages because there are hundreds of them coming in. Lyrics of a song, actually. All right. I suspected it might have been. Okay. Right. On we go. Question 7. Ah, phrasal verbs. Right. So you're really good at ice hockey. You should the team. Try out the team. Try out for the team. Try with the team. Or try on the team. So you're really good at ice hockey. You should the team. And this means try and get on. Try and join. Okay. Phrasal verb. Which one goes in the correct? What's the correct one to go in the blank space? A, B, C, or D. 3 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Try out for. You should try out for the team. So let's do it differently. Let's look at the wrong answers first. So to try out is to test something new to see whether you like it or not. You should try out the cafe in the city center. I think you'd like it. You should try out my new guitar. It sounds lovely. So it's to test something and see, do you like it? Do you not like it? To have a go and try something, or can be to do or go somewhere once to see whether you like it or not. So that's try out. Try with is not a phrasal verb and it doesn't fit logically or grammatically. Try on means to put on a new piece of clothing to see whether it fits or whether you like it. So I've ordered a new jacket from somewhere online. It looks good, but I won't know whether it fits until I try it on. So to put on some clothes, see whether you like it, see whether it fits. Nice to try on. Try out for, which is the correct answer, means to try and become a member of a team, or to try and become a member of a play or film. So this is often done through a trial or an audition. So I think you should try out for the role of, I think you should try out for the role of Lady Macbeth. You'd be perfect for it. The auditions are next week. See you there. Or the football trials are next week. I'm thinking of trying out for them. So it's when you try and join a team through a trial or an audition of some kind. Well done if you got that right. Any questions? Okay, let's have a look. May I try it on? A very nice way, useful piece of language to use in a shop if you want to try on the clothes. Yes. Try on means to make sure it fits you or not. Yes, it does. Well done, Margarita. Okay, try on this skirt. Good. Let's have a look. Any other questions? Try it for. So this one, not quite, Badil, okay? So try out for means to try and join a team. Okay, so you should try on a formal dress. We'd love it, Huda. We would love it. Can I try it for BBC Learning English team? Okay, very good example sentence. I like it. If Jenny has noticed my book collection, my mini library here, yes, I am a Stephen Fry fan. I think most people in the UK are a fan of Stephen Fry. He's a national treasure. Darlene, nice example sentence. You should try out my new piano. It sounds lovely. I like it. Okay, try out that football field. You could, it would be a little bit unusual because you don't usually try out the field because they're usually pretty similar, but grammatically it works, yeah. Okay, Manuel, before you buy, and with trousers at the end, okay, before you buy these trousers, you'd better try them on. Good luck, Angel. Mr. Guardiola wants me to try it for the Manchester City team. Good luck with that, because that's a good team at the moment. Okay, Shailu, like Huda, wants to try it for the BBC Learning English team. You're going to try on the blouse. Yes, good. Okay. Okay. My friend has a magical voice. I advised her to try out for American Idol. Nice. An idol, no E, IDOL. So, here, you should try out for the IELTS exam. So, we wouldn't use try out for with an exam. It's when we use try out for when we want to join or have membership to something. Or when we want to be part of a film or some sort of acting role. Okay, so we wouldn't use it for an exam. Okay, and Guillaume has put a nice definition here. To try to become a member of a team or to get a part in a play or film by showing someone how well you can play or perform. That's exactly it. Okay, very, very good. Whew. You should try out for a debating society. Yes. Let's have a look. All right then, let's move on then. Whoops. Okay, round 8, our final question. The quiz is coming to an end soon, but we've got one last question, so stick around. Our adjective vocabulary question. Okay, so you know the trousers are playing well, but you need to write quickly. I'm familiar, everybody nowadays, typing as quick as you can. So, excuse me, okay. Just so helping everybody so that we know that it is plural. All right. So anyway, we're looking at the adjectives. One of these is not usually used to describe athletes. Which one is it? A, muscular. B, robust. C, flabby. D, energetic. E, flexible. Or F, agile. A, B, C, D, E, F. Which of these is not used to describe an athlete usually? And first time I put it up, there's a variety of answers, but this time it seems that most of you are going for C, flabby, which is the correct answer. So let's look at the other words. First, muscular. Have a lot of muscles. Be very strong. Robust. This means strong and healthy, but it also means that you don't suffer injuries very often. Whatever happens, you carry on going. Okay, you're strong, you're healthy, and you don't get injuries very easily. Energetic, have lots of energy. Flexible, this means that you are capable of bending your body easily without breaking it. Okay, so you're somebody who can bend. So in the Summer Olympics, the gymnastic team's very, very flexible. And then agile is a nice adjective, and I'll say one more, agile, because it doesn't necessarily sound how it looks, agile. And this means you are able to move quickly and easily, and you're very well coordinated. So somebody who's quick, speedy, they can move around very well, fast, they've got a lot of pace, agile, very well coordinated. Flabby means when you've got an extra layer of fat, okay? So a little bit fat, so on the side of your belly, I'm a little bit flabby, okay? It can mean at the back of many people's arms, a little bit flabby here. So does flabby mean weak? Not really. Flabby means a little bit overweight. Let's have a look. I'm just checking any more questions. No questions. Evgeny, flabby is more suitable for people who are couch potatoes. Indeed. Yes, indeed. Okay. And anything else here? So no questions here. Oh, nice. Here, Ted, robust is for resilient athletes. Yes. Somebody who does not get injured easily, who's very resilient, robust is a great adjective to use. Esther, oh my gosh, it's been my worst weekly quiz. 3 out of 8. I know you usually do very well. So it happens to the best of us. Okay. Better luck next week. All right, then. Anything else? Okay, that's it then, guys, for today. So, well done. Okay, I know it's a few tricky questions today, but we covered a lot of vocabulary. We did some nice grammar. We had some phrasal verbs. We learned a lot, I hope. So, good job. With loads of example sentences, which were spot on. If you like more lessons, be sure to check us out at bbclearningenglish.com, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. We've got loads of content, loads and loads of it. For whatever you need, I'm sure we've got something for you. And then we've got more live content. So on Monday, every other Monday, we have vocabulary lessons, Facebook and YouTube. Tuesday and Thursday, we have Pronunciation Live with Nina, and I think Roy will be joining you in Pronunciation Live soon as well. And then Wednesday, grammar class, and Friday, of course, is the quiz. See you same time next week. Bye, everybody. Have a great weekend. Bye.